Can Hindus prove that the world we're living in now is reality?
Okay. You see, the question can be asked not to Hindus, but to anybody and everybody. How can you be sure that the world that you experience here and now is real? How can you be? And you know, Bernard Russell, the great philosopher, asked, how can you be sure about an objective reality? Same question fired at a major thinker, a very clear thinker, Russell. And he said something very interesting. He said, the only way I can be sure there's an objective reality, there's a table here, because we all agree on it, because it's common experience. So the only way you can be sure about the external world as a reality, not a dream, is because we all agree. This is a table, this is a chair, I'm wearing an orange jacket. So that is why, if you like, the only thing that you got is commonality, common experience. Does it prove that the world still exists? Because maybe all of us are using the same mindset to make sense of the world. So that, because you're using the same mindset, we are in a way duped by the mindset telling all of us, yes, there's a table. Now where do I get authority to talk like this? Physics. It's saying the material world you are so fixated on. This is beautiful stuff out of Erwin Schrodinger, one of the fathers of quantum physics. Is the world that you are so sure about is this material world. This is what is, these are his words. He said, matter is an appearance. So everything you say is me. You can see me as a matter, material being, the table, the chair, the houses, the galaxies. He said, my friend, says quantum physics, matter is an appearance. Then you say, of course, the next question is, then what is reality? He said, don't ask me. I'm confounded. In fact, he was so rattled by quantum physics, he said, I want to give up the whole field because it's so unusual, counterintuitive, that I really don't know how to define what is underpinning this reality. But he said, the quantum physics says, it is not matter. It is not matter. Matter is an appearance. Matter is a paradox. Quantum phenomena is reality. But how do you define quantum phenomena except use a lot of mathematical squiggles? No conceptual idea whatsoever, right up to now.